Cafe Nova and welcome to our reaction to Michael Jackson, and we are going to react to the song Smooth Criminal. Let's get started with this.
Yeah, I think it's Kirti's first time reaction, not mine. I've heard this song many times before.
Okay. Nice. This was fun to listen to. It had a lot of energy and a lot of fun factors in the song. When it started, I liked the bass guitar tune of the entire song, the basic tune of the song created by the bass guitar. It's very easy to go, and it also sounds similar to some other, maybe one song, but I can't recollect the exact tune of the Michael Jackson, similar tune like that. And when he was saying, Annie, are you okay? It was like, Annie, are you walking? Walking. You know, the way the song is sung by him as well as the backup singers, as if they're singing in a different language altogether. When it just started, it felt like they're singing Japanese or something, not English altogether. So it's a different way of, you know, them pronouncing certain things and making it sound fun. But it sounded great. It sounded great. Great music, great vocals, amazing song.
Yeah, it was fun to listen to it after quite a while, few years at least. A lot of fun to listen to this one. And though it's a very serious thing happening,
yeah,
he's asking again and again, Annie, are you okay? Seems like she's been struck by,
and
she's
seems
been
like
hit
a
by a smooth criminal.
Yeah.
Yeah, so where very few artists and bands in the history of modern music can pull a song like this off.
Yeah.
It's very repetitive in the lyrics, limited lines. It's repeated 3, 4, 5 times maybe. That Annie, are you okay? But it's repeated so many times, maybe 20 times totally. That Annie, are you okay line. But very few artists and bands in the history of modern music can make it sound as catchy and groovy, as cool as Michael Jackson does. And that's a highlight, that's a hallmark, that's a sterling quality, that even though it's repeated sometimes, the main lines, it sounds so wonderful. You want more of it. You get addicted to it. You know, and in a good way. In a good way, you get addicted to it and you want more and more of it. It's like a Satya Nag Champa incense stick. It's so good, that flowery sandalwood fragrance, the oils which when lit, it just spreads such wonderful, beautiful, attractive aroma. Attractive may be the wrong word, but I actually just want to be so close to it,
it
and be there in that area where it's lit for hours on end, you know. So that's how Michael Jackson's voice is. He pulls off the inevitable. Inevitable. People can't do this.
You know, Savio, one thing common between both Satya Nag Champa and Michael Jackson, they both had and have international appeal. So does this song.
Yeah, Satya Nag Champa is an incense stick brand that is famous worldwide. From Germany to Timbuktu and Mumbai to LA. And Michael Jackson, I think he was even more popular. Much,
yeah,
much more popular than Satya Sai Baba Nag Champa will ever be.
Yeah.
Yeah, of course I love the incense sticks, but you get my point.
That's all. Welcome to Cafe Enoma and welcome to our reaction to Bob Marley, and we are going to react to the song Jamming. Let's jam in.
So first time single take honest reaction by both of us. Let's get started.
Simple song about jamming. I hope you like jamming too. I like it. I like it. And I hope you like jamming with us too. That too. And there is something, you know, about Bob Marley. No matter what he sings, it sounds musical. No matter what he would start singing, I think. Any word he would take and sing that same word for many, many, many times and it would sound musical. Automatically, forget about the music that plays along, it's very trippy music anyway, but the way he sings, it just can't fail, whether it is No Woman, No Cry or Get Up, Stand Up, anything he sings, it sounds musical.
Yeah, this was a really good song. I remember hearing it now, very catchy, and jamming can be have different meanings here.
How?
And it's
in this context,
though it's a cool song to listen to, groovy, cool, catchy. Yeah, like Kirti said, whatever he's narrating, whatever he's singing, it just sounds so musically divine. Beautiful.